Humans are creators and users of data. We have been gathering data since the first knot was tied by our ancestors. With computers and the internet permeating every aspect of modern life, the volume of data today has seen an explosive increase. China has one of the largest and most diverse volumes of data in the world. People today are much better at collecting, storing, and processing data. This makes it possible for various data applications to profoundly change the way we work and live. If agriculture represents ancient civilization and industry stands for modern civilization, then big data could herald a brand new type of civilization. China is entering this new era at an unprecedented speed. Data is being produced the moment you pick up your cell phone. Text and photos are stored and processed in the form of data. When you read news and watch videos, computers are working to read and analyze data. With the rapid development of mobile internet and Internet of Things technology, the types and volume of data are growing globally at a phenomenal rate. According to industry forecasts, the total amount of data in the world in 2020 will exceed 40 zettabytes. This is equivalent to every single person in China watching movies nonstop for a total of 7 years. Many countries have sped up big data analysis and application and made it part of their national strategy. Data is the new oil, and the source of this oil is enhanced technology.
如果我们今天没有互联网，那么我们的信息就零碎的分散的过处，而且都是量也不会很大，所以这互联网呢已经普遍的发展应用。此外呢，我们这个计算机本身能力的发展，包括存储能力啊、处理能力，数据量都很大的情况，我想我们过去这些电脑都没法处理，但是我们现在像云计算中心几十万、几百万个服务器。
The development of the internet, combined with improved storage and computing capacity, can now give us digital wisdom. Big data can learn about your preferences and recommend just the right products. It can bring insights into city operations and solve city management problems. It can also uncover natural laws and predict disasters. The clash of different data brings us closer to ourselves as well as the unknown world.
看我，看我，再讲个看我啊，东张西望。 算你懒洋洋的啊，让贵宾拿球，不是这样拿球的，就这样给，好抬头，好抬头，哎这边，就这种紧张的节奏。我要知道。Wei Fei
is a football coach at Longhu Primary School in Shantou, Guangdong Province. Selecting players is the hardest part of the job. In the past, he could only rely on experience, which could lead to good players being overlooked.
我们当时选拔队员呢，说实话是纯粹的基于经验，当然也有个人的喜好。Wei
Fei is trying to change the recruiting process so that more talented children can be selected and trained. The person he's going to visit today might be able to help him do that.
这个教练，您可以看到，我们用这样的一个形式，就可以知道每个球队在这个比赛过程中它的具体的一个数据对比。Chen
Yuei-Chiang is a sports data researcher who has been doing data analysis for professional football clubs for a long time. He and his team have created a new system focusing on youth training. This system can help players learn how to practice and compete in a more scientific way. Today, Chen Yuei-Chiang has brought some mysterious equipment.
那教练，我们现在已经为每个学生绑定那个适配带，绑在那个活动脚的一个外层，然后进行一个绑定，大概这样子。然后这样训练过程之后呢，所有的数据我们都会汇总到这个平台里面来。This
little device will collect data on how the children perform. Inside it are several sensors that can collect comprehensive data on the player's physical condition, endurance, speed, muscular power, and shooting frequency.
好，现在我们进行的是脚内侧的盘球啊，脚速快点，啪，跟上球，哎。现在这些科技的手段，让小孩子的这个选材更精准。
The data collected by sensors gives an objective assessment of every player's performance. By comparing the data, they can also clearly see each player's characteristics.
长大了以后，他就变成这个人的一个历史数据、大数据。比如说你的能力，说在某些方面比梅西还好，同年龄的话，那我们就培养你，挖掘你这方面的能力，那有可能就是有的放矢的会培养出一个，另外一个梅西或者说超出梅西的这样的一个球员。
Being able to select talented young players should make Wei Fei feel pleased. But he still has some worries. The problem is not the kids or the parents. It's himself. While he's now able to select talented players, he hasn't yet found a science-based training method. In the 2014 World Cup in Brazil, Germany discarded its typical soccer machine and became champions through outstanding tactics and smooth cooperation. This change was made as a result of data analysis, which created strategies based on each player's features. In effect, Big Data was the team's 12th player.
本队比赛赢了多少分啊，对吧，他整个一个生涯赢了多少分，这些非常精细，这种训练啊，他们这种措施啊，他们这种规则程度啊，要比国内要先进很多的。
Today, Chen Yuqiang is bringing these scientific methods to Wei Fei.
军训过程中，一个标准动作是怎么去实现的？其实我们可以用一些 3D 建模的模型，一种更生动形象的一些形式来了解这个动作怎么去达标。
Through data comparison, the coach can even learn about subtle changes in a player's body in one short training session.
有没有紧张？
没有。
对，我们组队的时间比他们长。
The young players are excited about the competition Wei Fei has organized. Everyone is curious about how much they've achieved. Wei is also eager to see if the system is effective.
1, 2, 3, 好球，抬头，给，拿住，贵宾，给，好球。
每个训练球员他的历史数据跟一些训练数据累积出来，看到了一些内容之后，我们可以去看他适不适合打某个位置。从数据体现出来，你可以圈领啊，这个球员的一个整体的维度的数据其实更优于打前锋，或更优于打后卫啊。其实这种数据模型可以帮助到教练，帮助到个人啊，去达到更好的位置。
这个数据没有来测试之前呢、确实不懂，因为他刚上来没多久，我们还观察不到位，他在不停的调整。
文正啊，都给球，调整，好球。
他应该适合打前锋，他脚头比较硬。
对着我什么都没有，
对吧？那你就练，好好练好那个射门动作。大家喜不喜欢这样的数据表现？对自己。
以后我们就带这个来训练。以后
带这样训练好不好？
看你们有没有提高。
The more data the coach can get, the better positions and strategies he can come up with for the players. These methods could give rise to many future football stars. We can never know how many coaches have missed out on turning professional, like Wei Fei, and how many talents have been overlooked. Wei Fei hopes that the data system can be effective and that more children can become involved in football.
它跟这个社会的发展一定是同步的。我希望在不仅仅在科技助力的情况下，在其他社会各个方面、各个不同的这个领域或者说不同的行业，都能够给中国足球以更大的支持。
Data mining and application are profoundly changing the traditional way we work and think.As we enter this new era, it's more than likely that the Chinese football stars of the future will be discovered not by coaches, but by big data. By the end of 2017, there were 240.9 million people aged over 60 in China, making up 17.3% of the total population. The world's most populous country is facing a severe aging problem. But it's a problem that big data could help to solve. The neighborhood committee has been receiving calls like this and helping out elderly people since January 2018. All the information comes from the grid management center of Jing'an District. The platform is still in its test phase, but it could be part of our lives in the future.
这个数据来源是我们通过了，就是在这个老人的家里面装了这个给老人相关的这些传感器，然后采集来的。那可能我们会包括了很多像这个老人的这个家里的门池啊，然后家里面的这个烟感啊，家里的温感啊，红外啊，这些生命体征的这些数据，然后汇聚到这个平台。
Ning Xiaoqing is one of the people who built the platform. The main purpose of the system is to prevent elderly people from having accidents at home. Ning became part of this project 3 years ago and is mainly responsible for tracking elderly people's everyday trajectories. It will take a long time to finish building the system, as huge amounts of data are needed to learn about each person's routines and habits.
积累这个老人，比如说他平常，比如说从卧室到客厅，或者从卧室到厨房，那他这些时间间隔大概是多少？那我们基于历史的这个数据，然后根据每个老人会有一个去算他本身的大概的一个值，然后根据这个值来设一个阈值。This
is just the beginning. As an international metropolis, Shanghai has a very serious aging problem. Jing'an District is already in an advanced stage of aging. The number of elderly people is over 100,000, which means that one out of every three people here is a senior citizen.
我们的社区，就是我们小区啊，老龄化程度是蛮高的，就是60岁以上的老人要占比要40%，将近40%。 像我们小区来说，独居老人和纯老户，子女都不住在这里的，就是自己一个人或者两个老人住在这里。那么，如何就是服务好我们的老人，是我们居委会重中之重的任务。In
addition to data on individual behavior, elderly people's physical data is also needed to make a judgment about whether a person is safe. This test aims to obtain data from an elderly person's vital signs. The device being tested is not medical equipment or a sophisticated instrument. It's simply a mattress fitted with sensors.
它通过检测人在心跳和呼吸过程中微弱的振动信号，来获取人的一些最基本的生命体征，比如说心跳的每分钟的次数，啊，就是还有呼吸每分钟的次数。
Detecting human heartbeat and breathing from a weak vibration is no easy task. Specialized medical equipment is used to inspect the mattress quality.
屏幕上这个是一个老人半年的睡眠的一个数据，这个蓝色的表示人在床上，这个白色的呢表示人不在床上。他的夜间的睡眠我们也看到经常起夜，那这是一个比较典型的不规律的老人的数据。那实际上这个老人呢，他是有认知症的一个老人。验证一下心率变化哈，做一组俯卧撑，狂做啊。好，躺中间，平静啊，平静，不要紧张啊，深呼吸。
In the future, data engineers will aggregate the data taken from the mattress with the data collected by other devices in the house to make a more comprehensive analysis. This will lead to more accurate predictions for the elderly person's health condition.
我们可以根据心跳、呼吸、这个起床的次数啊，甚至我们还看老人，比如说这个在床上睡觉的时候，这个翻身的这个次数。有些老人，哎，他平常睡觉其实算比较平稳。什么叫做比较平稳呢？就是他可能晚上这个翻身的这个次数啊，跟平常是比较一致的。那有的时候我们会发现，哎，他某些晚上那个在床上这个动的这个次数啊，会特别多。那这个时候其实我们有个像街道啊，去跟他们反馈这个问题。那接着，那我们去上面去看，老人说，哎，他最近其实可能身体不是很舒服。那有的时候不只是身体，有的时候我们还看他心情也不是很好，也可能比如说家里面可能儿女不在呀，长时间没有回来呀，哎，这种他也会有一些影响。那这个时候可能怎么说，社区可能就会跟他说，哎，这个老人可能近期需要去关怀。
As the test has gone smoothly, more smart mattresses will be installed in the community.They will collect data 24 hours a day and send it to the central platform. This accumulated data will effectively show old people's daily routines and health conditions. If anything out of the normal occurs, the platform will raise the alarm.The responsibilities of adult life make it increasingly difficult to make sure your parents and elderly relatives are safe. Ning Xiaoqing has created a system that can ease adults' burdens while protecting senior citizens.
主要我们就因为像我们自己在上班的时候，其实你给老人的这个能够也不能成天待在一起，那我们就通过这种方式，其实能够把这个老人出现的这些问题。能够及时发现，然后告诉他的这个相关的人，我们觉得其实还是比较有意义的。
Big data is becoming an important tool for social development and raising living standards. Its digital signals can make sure that society keeps its senior citizens safe.Jing'an District is a microcosm of the ways in which Chinese people's lives have improved. Big data-based care for the elderly can never replace children's love, but can help children to better care for their parents.
Big data-based care for the elderly can never replace children's love, but can help children to better care for their parents. 关键是他把中间的很多规律性的东西给你找出来了，所以我们在这一个数字化时代、数字化生存的时代，我们怎么样这个在认识问题、分析问题、解决问题的过程中间，用数据来帮助我们。
In China, the best medical resources are concentrated in Beijing, Shanghai, and Guangzhou. These regions have the top doctors, best medical facilities, and most advanced treatments. This uneven distribution of resources makes it difficult for people in smaller cities and rural areas to get quality medical treatment.
其实国际也是一样的，肯定是在这种大型一线城市呢是最发达的。
Li Xiaopeng researches medical big data. He wants to use big data to solve this problem of distribution so that more people can enjoy better medical care.He believes that the key lies in replicating experts' skills and that data will play a crucial role in the process. Many Chinese prefer older doctors as they have more experience. This experience comes from the number of cases they have worked.Li Xiaopeng is trying to get machines to learn from doctors' previous cases and diagnosis experience. While reading patients' information and diagnosis is relatively simple for machines, other complicated data concerning the human body is still beyond their reach.
对于国际来说都是一个难题，因为医疗数据很复杂，它里面包含了结构化数据。比如说一些检查单、检验单，还有一些非结构化数据，比如说那个医生的诊断报告，还有影像报告，还有影像的图片，这些都属于非结构化数据。
Doctors must go through long periods of learning and practice before they can read abstract medical images. Passing on these specialized professional skills to machines is an extremely difficult task.
我觉得这个东西呢，它毕竟得需要，比如说这个片子是什么，诊断的是什么，分级啊、分期啊等等，这还是说有病理大夫先得给他诊断出来。
Li Xiaopeng then turns his attention to diagnosis reports made by experimental doctors. Although it's difficult for machines to process pictures, they can understand text and numbers.Li believes that machines learning those reports first would represent a major breakthrough.
那么为了解决这个问题，我们让机器学习的平台学习了很多医学的一些文献和标准，来分析一个医生的一个诊断报告。那我们可以从中提出，比如说诱因、发病时间，根据这些特征，然后我们给这些数据打上不同的标签。
Labeling data creates links between the terms used in doctors' diagnoses and patients' medical images. As links are established, the machine can extract the relevant keywords when it sees the image, and thus understand it.
Just like the Chinese AlphaGo, 那个是一样的道理，它是把什么图谱啊什么这些都给你存进去。这样呢，它实际通过大量的这种图片，然后用计算机的方法去识别，那么给出诊断。
Making the correct diagnosis is a basic part of a doctor's job. Delicate operations are more challenging. They say that a surgeon needs 10,000 hours of experience to master his craft. In a county-level hospital,That could take 20 years. China's population is huge, and the number of experts is limited. A new approach is needed to relieve the huge pressure on medical services and help doctors in grassroots hospitals. These doctors are using 3D technology to help them with this operation. This system is one of the most advanced in the world.It first obtains 2D medical image data and then remodels the organ in 3D. Based on the 3D model, doctors can simulate a surgery before performing the real one.
总体来说，这是一个术前应用数字化的一个技术，把患者的个体化的 CT 带入我们这个软件里边，通过三维重建模拟手术，能达到一个术前做手术中计划虚拟手术的这么一个作用，让我们患者能够手术更安全，让我们医生呢手术更有数。
Before the operation, the doctor uses this system to stimulate the surgery, while the machine records every step. During the real operation, the machine will provide 3D guidance based on simulated procedures. This helps the doctor perform the surgery as precisely as possible and also keeps detailed records of the doctor's operating techniques.Every major technological breakthrough in human history has brought a leap in medical care. The ultimate goal of science and technology is to improve our quality of life. In the future, when machines can gain more experience from specialists, they will become smarter and thus better help grassroots doctors perform complicated surgeries.
比如说我做一个前列腺癌根治手术，把所有的做得很好的大夫的这个手术的这个步骤录下来，数字分析以后综合起来，如果上百个专家，机器是不是能比所有单个的专家可能技术还要好？
The rapid development in information technology and big data has led to the formation of a digital space that can reflect reality.Soon, people will no longer have to travel long distances to see a good doctor or to line up for hours to book appointments. Big data application has changed the way people think about and solve problems. It's breaking through boundaries and creating larger and better spaces for us to live in.
大气扩散条件略差。
你好，
你好，
我们是包头市环境监察支队的，这是我证件。
Li Shifeng is the leader of the Baotou Environmental Inspection Team. He's heading into this industrial area to check on a suspected source of pollution.
看一下，大概是不是这个位置？
对对
对。对于这些污染企业呢，我们的工作呢？其实就是断了他们财路，他经常在这个检查过程中给我们打游击。
就这个是他的排口呗？这个应该不是。
After checking several discharge outlets, they find nothing suspicious. Finding concrete evidence of wrongdoing in such a large area is no easy task if they rely only on experience.
这上面呢有这个总共呢是全区是目前是146个自动检测站，其中呢国家的自动站呢是44个，102个呢是我们自治区控的站点，这样整个是分布全区的146个空气自动站点的分布情况。
Fan Qingyun is a researcher at the Inner Mongolia Air Quality Early Warning and Forecast Platform.His job is to predict the air quality for the coming 7 days based on pollution data from the monitoring stations. The 146 stations are scattered around the whole region, forming a huge net that covers all the key areas in Inner Mongolia. When an area is blanketed in haze, the platform will provide a statistical basis for enterprises to shut down for an appropriate period. But the real threat comes.From illegal emissions from companies, which are not covered by the monitoring net. Inner Mongolia is 1.18 million square kilometers in area, which means each station must monitor an average area of 8,000 square kilometers.
因为内蒙古自治区吧，面积比较大，所以东西的这个距离比较长。如果说全靠人工去监控，
还有监察，这个是跑不过来的，就是属于就看山跑死马这么一个状态。
比如说咱们在包头市可以划分出 N 个这个网。
Zhou Dongping set up the Inner Mongolia Environment Monitoring Platform. He and his team are trying out a new solution.
在不久的将来，我们为了提高大气防治的精细化水平，我们会建立微型的大气监测站，采集这些站点的数据。
Joe and his team are going to add more micro air monitoring stations to the existing 146 stations in the autonomous region. These micro stations will have a grid layout, filling in the current blind spots and making air quality monitoring more intensive and accurate. By tracking the trajectories of the pollutants, the system can provide law enforcement personnel with accurate locations of the pollution sources. In the future, the government will use this system to control pollution sources to defend our blue skies. Jilin Province, Northeast China. In 2 months, this vast rice field will enter its harvest period. But farmer Leo Bean is anxious, as it is now the peak season for rice blast, a disease that could decimate his crop. These 8 acres of rice field form the family's main source of income. According to Leo's experience, it is very likely his rice will become infected.
In this 多雨、雨后、高湿、高温，这么容易发到蚊病。
The rain brings a looming threat. Each year, the disease destroys 500,000 tons of rice in China and stays with the rice for its entire life cycle. This disease develops quickly, so it's crucial to apply insecticides at exactly the right time. Leo Bean has been farming his whole life, but still finds it difficult to seize the right moment.
打药呢，这个时机呢，得啥呢？得晴天打药，另外还得避开中午。你本身它就阴天，阴天就是下一天雨不可能得病。等下几天雨了，这个病菌已经形成了，这个防治呢就没啥必要了。
哎，来来，你好，你好。
哎，雷总，你好。
你好，你好。Leo Bean's worries could be eased by a group of special guests who come to visit him.Wu Longchun is a plant protection professional.
我以前是学那个植保的，对，然后2015年的时候就开始那个做这个大数据这块。
But Wu Longchun will not be referring to textbooks to help Leo Bean prevent plant disease. He'll be using big data.Chinese people were already applying data to agricultural production over 2,000 years ago. Even back then, the data came from experience accumulated over centuries of trial and error.
下雨大家说早下不出门，晚下行千里，或者有些局部地区看见月亮边上有个光圈，就知道明天要下雨。这类都是过去的人的。尝试这些尝试的背后也是从数据中提炼出来的一些结论。
咱这个需要挖一个30×40长跟宽的这么一个坑，精准地控制它这个水位的高低。
Instead of observing the stars for his data, Wu Longchun will use sensors to collect it in order to analyze and learn the rules.
这发无线电那边那个相连接，它不需要电线电缆，所有的这种就是数据采集完之后都通过 通过这个小的无线天线传输到我们那边这个主机站里面去。
These devices can detect air temperature, air humidity, and soil moisture within a 3-kilometer radius. The collected data will be used to build models and predict rice growth. This small sensor plays a key role in the process. It can measure the leaf's temperature, which is an important factor in predicting rice blast. Placing the sensor in the right place is critical for accuracy.
中间层的叶子的话，相对来说就发育都比较健全，呼吸跟光合作用也比较强，所以我们一般选择在中间层，就是第三跟第四张叶子，它正处于这个青壮年的阶段，就是比较有代表性。
The engineers will install more than 10 types of data collecting facilities.This will allow all the data to be transmitted to the data platform in real time, showing farmers the right time to sow and harvest, thus boosting production. But more importantly, it will also help them prevent plant diseases.
冬病的爆发跟发生，是在一定的条件之下才能够发生的。所以我们通过这种就是传感器去采集它的一些相关的一些数据。用这个数据的形式把这个植物的一些生理需要或者说植物的一些这个特性展现出来，那么经过一系列的模型跟算法，最终会得到一个相对精准的这么一个就是预警信息。那么这个预警信息的话，可以指导我们农户去在一个相对精准的时间段去喷药或采取一些防治措施。
The rice in northeast China is near its booting stage, the most critical period of its growth. If the rice gets through this stage, everything will be fine. But the August heat and September rain bring high temperatures and humidity, creating perfect conditions for rice blast. Leo Bean's worst fear becomes a reality.Humans have struggled with nature for thousands of years. Courage is necessary in this struggle, but wisdom is more important. Today, big data technology is bringing us this wisdom, helping to solve this agricultural problem that has troubled mankind for thousands of years.
您只要是预测预报的准，然后选准打药的最佳时期。选对防治的药剂应该是可防可控的。
This is good news for Leo Bean. Through real-time monitoring and analysis of the temperature, humidity, light, and wind in the rice field, the experts finally give him an accurate time to apply insecticides.The problem that has plagued farmers for thousands of years has been solved by our generation. Leo can now look forward to a big harvest. With his job here complete, Wu Long Chuan will now meet a group of special guests from overseas.
我们要迎接一批来自联合国环境署的专家们到我们项目地来考察这个大数据的试点应用。
This is our project manager, Mr. Wu Longchun.
The purpose of their tour is to introduce China's big data applications in agriculture into other countries and regions. Food is the paramount necessity of the people. For thousands of years, we have depended on grain for survival and growth. But now, the traditional methods of farming are changing. Big data can help in the entire farming process, from seed breeding to harvesting. Today's technology allows us to better obtain resources from nature, make rational use of nature, and live in harmony with nature.
The
new generation of information technology has turned the world into a global village. Product circulation is becoming data circulation, and industrial labor is becoming information labor. Humans are ushering in a new period of big data discovery. China has just completed the first 5 years of its national big data strategy. As a new strategic resource, big data will serve as a powerful engine for China's innovation and development. The curtain on a digital China is being lifted.